There's one. First one of the day. Got me spooked. Is it big or not? Oh, that's a good one. Better than I thought. Right when it hit, little guy nailed it. About a pounder, I just said. We'll see. It's stuck in something. Uh-oh. Got the weeds. Thought we're done with the summer weed stuff. Oh, yeah, it's a nice one. Alright. Nice chunk. It's pretty cloudy and foggy out here today, so I went ahead and went with the this pearl and a chartreuse. Heading Super Spook Junior. Nice chunk, about a pound and a half. Let him go. Good lord, that was a big bass out there. Jeez. Oh man, I don't have the casting. It'll get all the way out there though. Oh boy. Yolo. Oh, that wasn't bad. Ah, short. Man, that was a big bass out there. God, that's probably like a 6.5 to 6 pounder easy. Hit it, missed it, and came back for it. That was, another solid one. Oh, the jerk bait, a nice one. Jeez. Oh man, it's gonna be tough landing this guy. Try to get down here. Alright, we're good. Beautiful fish. Come here, buddy. Switch it up using a Lucky Craft pointer, smaller version 78, just taking it above the grass line. A little bottleneck here, great area to catch some fish. Another beautiful fall fish, nice and healthy, fat tummy. Let him go. When imitating shad, there's three main color patterns I like to use. If it's sunny out, I like to use a chrome colored or reflective coated bait to replicate the natural flash that shad have when they're darting around. If it's cloudy out, I can use a pearl or pink colored bait. This way you get maximum visibility under those cloudy conditions. And if there's an abundance of shad around, I can use a bait that stands out a little bit. Either a pearl with a chartreuse tip or a all chartreuse type bait. This way it gives a bass a target to single out if they have so much bait to choose from. I stuck on a weed. Do I have a fish? I don't even know anymore. Alright, let's just pull this in and find out. That's a fish. It's a little baby. This, I don't even think it's a bass, to be honest. Holy moly. Switch it up to a Strike King. Red Eye Shad. Got this little baby. But even the babies are fat. I don't know if you guys can tell, this guy is well fed. But yeah, the weeds weigh more than this guy. That's why I got a little fooled. Ripping out this grass here. I forgot what they call this, but I'm sure one of you can help me out with that. Hey, buddy. Got him. Oh, look at the baby. Push to a slim jig. Because these leaves are ridiculous, but it's not the size I'm looking for. It's smaller on me. Dang it, had the flare for over 10 years. Looks like I'll have to come back in the summer to go and get it. It's all good. All right. Good way to spend the morning. Out of time now. I'll be leaving to Ohio tomorrow morning to go fish with John B over the weekend. So you guys can look forward to some more great videos coming up next week.